The views expressed on this program do not necessarily reflect those of this station.
Welcome to Insights into Northeast Michigan, a WBKB News public affairs program. Insights deals with the issues affecting those in the community, as well as Northeast Michigan and the state. And now, Insights into Northeast Michigan.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Insights. Today on the show, I am sitting down with a couple people from the Boys and Girls Club, and my first guest is Jen. How are you today?
Great, thank you for having me.
And what is your position here with the Boys and Girls Club?
I'm the unit director of the Boys and Girls Club of Alpena.
Okay, so tell me a little bit about, to start off, what does the Boys and Girls Club do here in town?
We are a youth-serving organization, and we are open for kids ages 6 to 18.
Okay, and how long have you guys been open for?
We have been actually open since 1926.
Wow, so that's a really long time.
Yeah.
So you guys are very active in the community then, correct?
Yes.
And what do you do for, you said kids ages 6 to 18, is that right?
Yes, it's actually a really wide range of kids. But we are open after school. We do a bunch of after school programs, you know. We serve a supper every day at 4:30. We have a full-size gym. We help with homework, you know. And we really try and split up the kids by age group. You know, for our teenagers, we have a great volunteer program. And then, you know, for our younger members, we have a bunch of, you know, learning activities for them. We have an arts program. We have science. We have a lot of hands-on things for them, too. We really try to incorporate learning into everything that we do. But the main thing is for them to have fun.
So is the Boys and Girls Club, is it mainly a place that kids in the community can come and interact with each other?
Yes, it's a great place for them to just have fun, and it's a positive place. It is, you know, where they can come and hang out with their friends, and they can just meet new people, too.
So do you have kids show up here every day?
Yes, we have a wide range of kids, you know, from ages 6 to 18 show up every day after school. We open the doors at 2 o'clock, and we stay open Monday through Thursday from 2 to 6, and then Fridays from 2 to 5. And then on days when they don't have school or snow days, we open at noon. On half days, we open at 10:30.
Okay, now what's the atmosphere like in here when you have all of these kids here hanging out?
It's very fun and energetic. We make sure that the kids are just happy. A lot of laughter happens in our building.
And you said you have different programs for the different age groups, correct?
Yes, we definitely try and split up the age groups as much as we can. And we try and divide the building by the age groups. The teens have their own separate room, which is, you know, the teen zone. And they get to go in there and just listen to music and chill and kind of get away from the younger ages. And then, you know, all activities are facilitated by a staff member. So, you know, we don't have the younger members in the gym by themselves. It's always facilitated by a staff member. And, you know, we split them up in the gym by age group also, and we try to incorporate, you know, the older members to help out with the staff, and sometimes we let them play, you know, kickball and stuff together, but games like dodgeball where it gets a little bit rougher,
right,
we try to, you know, keep them separate.
Yeah, to keep the violence
yes,
down in the games.
Definitely.
Now, can any kid in the community come and hang out and participate in your programs?
Most definitely. We do ask that they have a membership form on file, just so then we have a contact number and, you know, some information and some background on them.
So what do kids do if they want to sign up for your programs?
All they have to do is come in and have their parents fill out a form. If they would like to just try it out for a day, that's fine, or even a couple days. We have visitor forms for that purpose.
Okay, now I understand for the holidays, you're working on a fundraiser program, correct? It's with Payless here in town.
Yes, it's actually a national program through Payless, and it's called Shoes for Kids. And it's to help parents during the holidays to kind of relieve that stress for the parents. And we are giving 100 of our members a pair of brand new shoes. And all the kids have to do and the parents is fill out some forms and we will take them on an in-store shopping trip to get a brand new pair of shoes.
Now, you said you've done this in the past, correct? What, is this the third year, is that right?
Yes, this is the third year doing it. So some of our kids that are newer have never done this. Mm-hmm. And it is, the feeling that they get is just pure joy. They're so excited. I had one kid run up to me and say, but I won't be here tomorrow. And it's like, no, this will take a little bit of time for us to do this. And, you know, if any parents are interested in having their kids, you know, experience this and go on an in-store shopping trip to Payless, please call the Boys and Girls Club. The number is 356-0214. We can get your child signed up as a member, and they can go on this in-store shopping trip. And it's a great experience. You know, it, the children, you know, like to go with their friends. It's kind of a fun thing for them to do.
Now, is Payless donating all of the shoes to the kids, or is there a way that people in the community can donate money to buy a pair of shoes for the kids?
It's actually a Payless corporation grant that we were granted, and we get to give 100 shoes.
Okay, so you get 100 shoes, so, and then you said parents, if they want to participate in this, can sign their child up for this?
Correct.
Now, what happens if you were to have over 100 children sign up for this?
If that happens, then what we would have to do is we have, you know, some different forms that we go through. Mm-hmm. We have, like, the TANF form that we would have to go through, and then by that we would have to go through a certain process.
Okay, and I know you said the kids get so excited about this, getting a new pair of shoes, and the best part, I'm sure, is they get to pick it out themselves. What's that like for you as someone who works here and a mentor for them? What's that like, seeing the joy on their face?
It's pretty humbling, you know, because these kids come here every day, and just to see how excited they get, it really makes it worthwhile.
Now, what day did you say this is taking place when they get to go to Payless?
We have a variety of days, so there's not one set day. We have many trips to take because it's 100 kids. Mm-hmm. So we have quite a variety of days, and, you know, we will take kids on the weekends if we have to. We will go after Boys and Girls Club hours. The staff and I are very dedicated, and we will do whatever we have to do.
All right. Well, I want to thank you, Jenny, for being here on the show with us and telling us about that grant. It's so wonderful that you guys are able to provide kids with shoes and a nice place to come hang out after school. So everyone in the community, I'm sure, appreciates everything you do.
Thank you.
All right. And stick around because we'll be right back after this. Welcome back, everyone. I'm still here at the Boys and Girls Club, and I'm sitting here with Ryan, who is the mentoring director, correct?
Correct.
Now, you are in charge of a lot of different mentoring programs, is that right?
Yes, we have primarily three different programs. Our most popular program is the Lunch Buddy program, where that fits to a lot of people's schedules, because even the busiest person can take time on their lunch and just go to an elementary school or a high school and go during recess or lunch and just have a good time with their mentee. Community-based mentoring is more and more what I need more mentors for. Mm-hmm. What that involves is it takes a kid out of the school setting or the Boys and Girls Club setting, and you can enjoy the activities that Alpena has to offer. I mean, even though Alpena is a small community, we still have a lot of things that we can do. So,
yeah.
Another one that I really even more want to get people involved with are high school bigs. So any high school big or teenager that has good grades or is a positive role model in the community, things like that, that's kind of the criterion that we look for in that too. So.
And what is the need here in the community for mentors?
To me, a lot of these teenagers and a lot of these younger students and club members, they come from maybe not the best of homes and, and broken homes. And so a lot of times that hour a week is probably some of their most positive times of the week, you know. Mm-hmm. So so that's kind of.
And if to talk about each little program a little bit, for the Lunch Buddies, what does that require of a mentor?
Really anything, not just necessarily the Lunch Buddy program, but the other programs, it requires an hour a week at least commitment. With the Lunch Buddy program, we try not to it's more or less of a program where if someone is not going to be maybe around for all that long, or if they're kind of uncertain on what's going to be going on in their life, or if they're not, you know, what a lot of people don't realize is that an hour a week, a desire to make an impact, is really all that you need, you know. Mm-hmm. And we do go through extensive background checks and make sure everything is good to go before we sign up a mentor with their mentee too. So.
And what effect does a mentor, or what effect can a mentor have on their mentee?
Well, this is kind of a side topic, but I'm a big percentage person and big numbers person, so I did a little bit of research online and things like that, and I found out that 31% of public high school students do not graduate on time.
Wow.
So
that's quite a big percentage.
Yes, it's people don't realize that, but and like it goes back to what I said again. It's like we have the power to help our youth be successful, and people don't realize how much little time it actually will take, you know, and commitment. It's a big commitment, but like I say, an hour a week or more, it goes a long ways.
Now, was that percentage you just mentioned, is that here in Alpena or nationwide?
Nationwide.
Yep. Nationwide. So, and you say all it takes is an hour a week or so spending with being a mentor to help improve them and lead them in the right direction?
Absolutely. I mean, of course, you're more than welcome to spend the whole day with your mentee if you'd like to, but we'll start with an hour, and then you'd be surprised and how much difference that can make in a young man or young lady's life. So,
and is the high school bigs, is that something new or just something you're in a lot of need for?
To my knowledge, I'm relatively still new to the position. It's been around forever. You know, it's been around for many, many years. And like with a lot of these programs, when I come in, my boss Brad, he says just to make these programs my own. So I've been kind of changing a few things here and there, not making any drastic changes, but you know, just trying to see what I deem fit that will best help out. So,
now, how can someone get involved and become a mentor if they would like?
There's a few different ways you can contact me. One, obviously, you can just come here to the club and you can speak with me at any time. You can call the main number, which is 356-0214, or you can email me at ryanherrick12@yahoo.com.
Okay, and I know there is a another program you're involved in. That is the Youth Academy. What is that about?
Correct. That's been around for a few years now, too. That's where court-adjudicated youth are ordered to run a military-style boot camp 3 days a week. Primarily in the past, we've utilized the Sheriff's Department, and they worked very, very closely with us. And usually on any given day, you'll have a probation officer, myself, and an officer here. Now we are working with the city police, which they're great. And just like the sheriff's department, they're firm but yet caring and compassionate. And Officer Hamp, Officer Colligan, and Officer Tim are the three main ones that split apart the 3 days. And they are doing excellent things with us. So,
now, what are some of the things you do with the kids in the academy?
Well, we do, a lot of people don't realize, is it's not just a military-type boot camp thing where they exercise, but we also go out in the community, too, so people don't just look at these kids as, oh, they're in trouble, they've done something they're not supposed to. They're just, a lot of them are really, really good kids. They've just made not such great decisions. So we'll do things like community service that we have been doing the last few weeks, APLEX on Mondays, and we'll go there for an hour or so. And a special thanks also to Norm and Larry there, who have been very gracious in letting us help out. And even though some of our kids aren't the greatest window washers in the world, but it's the thought and it's the that's all that matters. And they're there showing positive things. So.
So besides doing some boot camp style activities with them, they also do the community service, like washing windows. Now, are there other kids who attend Boys and Girls Club that do community service as well?
I think that's more towards like maybe a YVC with Matt Mashinsky, who more or less does that. But oftentimes there are kids from the Boys and Girls Club who are members here who want to participate in Youth Academy. So I'll just have them get permission from their parents, and they're more than welcome to participate as like a volunteer, and they'll help lead stretches and things like that. And Sometimes it can be rough in the gym. Yeah. I'm big on fitness and more so cardio than anything.
Right.
So they know when they have me, when there's no officers here, that they're going to be doing a lot of running. So.
So sometimes when they see you, do they say, "Uh-oh,
yeah, they'll
Ryan's
do,
here."
Yeah, they'll do a lot of laps, a lot of suicides, a lot of running. So, but it's not bad if they do well for the first half an hour, 45 minutes, and there are no complaints, and we'll do a sport or something like that for the last 15, 20 minutes, and then like basketball or something like that, you know.
And you're getting ready to start another program, Smoking Sensations.
Mm-hmm. I'm relatively new to that as well. It's an 8-week class, and it talks about the addresses and needs of tobacco for boys and girls. And I'm getting kind of used to that and preparing for that, but it looks to be like it'll be a good program that's been around for a few years as well. We just actually finished a program called Prime for Life, where Don Hardees from Catholic Human Services came in and instructed. It was about 6 weeks, and we talked all about the risks of alcohol and drugs and making better choices in life and things like that. So that was a good program that Youth Academy participated in as well. So
will Smoking Sensations just teach the kids about tobacco use and that sort of thing, or will it help maybe some kids who are already smoking to quit?
I think a little bit of both. As with Prime for Life and some of these programs, you can tell in some of these kids, the moment that they leave the door, that, you know, they won't take what they learned with them. But that one kid that you might have helped, it would be it'll all be worthwhile, you know. So there might be one out of 20 kids, but hey, and that's one more than it was before when we started the program, so.
Right. All right, Ryan. Well, we want to thank you for joining us on the show today. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
And stick around. We'll be right back after this. Welcome back to Insights, everyone. I'm sitting here with Brad Summers, and you're the executive director of the Boys and Girls Club, right?
Yes.
So what do you kind of do on a day-to-day basis?
Well, I'm in charge of running the day-to-day operations here at the club. You know, the human resource aspect of it, the resource development aspect of it, and the finance aspect of it, and applying for a lot of grants and, you know, doing the fundraiser stuff, the fun parts of the job.
Yeah. Now, do you ever get to interact with the kids?
I do. Actually, before I took over as the executive director, I worked with kids for about 12 years here at the Boys and Girls Club. I've been involved with the organization for almost 13 years. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I try to make time on a daily basis to go out and play a game of pool, or, you know, go in the gym and shoot some baskets or hoops with the kids, and, you know, play dodgeball or something like that. Just interact and get out and just, you know, kind of hang out with the kids a little bit.
Yeah. Now, with it being the holiday season in between Thanksgiving and Christmas, I know you guys are doing several fundraisers, and we've already talked about the Payless grant that's going on. But what are some of the other things you're doing to raise money?
Well, we have our big year-end event is coming up. It's called Buy a Bag for Kids' Sake. Mm-hmm. And that one is it's set up like a silent auction. We have a lot of area sponsors and people that donate in our community that put together bags, or baskets, or anything really that can hold an item. It could be gift certificates, it could be items from their store. It's a way for us to highlight some of the great partnerships that we have in the community, and all to raise, you know, money for the kids and continue doing these preventative programs here in Alpena at the Boys and Girls Club to help these kids out.
Now, when will this take place?
It happens Thursday, December 18th, from 6:30 to 8:30 at the Aplex. Mm-hmm. And tickets are $12 for the event. And we make it, $12 is actually what it costs to have one kid participate at the club each week.
Okay.
So it's kind of, when you buy a ticket, you're actually buying like a sponsorship to help out a kid here at the club. You know, and the things that go into that $12 are, of course, the staffing, the programs that we provide, and, of course, we have a free meal every day for the kids, a meal and a snack. So, you know, all these things come in as an expense, and, you know, we're very, very blessed to live in such a community that that really supports its kids and supports the programs that we do here.
Yeah, definitely. Now, how can the public get involved with this? Where can they donate items or that sort of thing?
Well, we always take donations here at the Boys and Girls Club at 601 River Street. And people can call. I'm willing to drive to pick up anything. Anything to help out the kids is really what it's all about. You know, they can call, they can email me. We try to have as much exposure as we possibly can. Doing programs like this helps us get out there and show people and propose that need to the community of what things that we could utilize. I mean, we could use anything from a basketball to a monetary donation, or even someone's time is very valuable to us. If they can provide a skill here at our club, come in and do an art project, or you know, have this interest that they would like to have kids. Of course, we do background checks for the safety of the kids, but we're always looking for people to come in to help out. And thankfully, we have a very good you know, support from people around at the health department, the court systems, you name it. We have people that come in to help us and teach the kids very valuable things in life.
Now, what are some of the items that you're looking to get, or how many baskets are you hoping to bring in for the silent auction?
Well, this is my second time around doing this fundraiser for the club. Last year, we had about 30 different bags. We're hoping to have that be on the same par as that this year. Right now, I think we're about at our goal for the bags. It's just one of those things where, I mean, we could take 100 different bags.
Right.
But it's what the community is willing to help out with. And we just kind of put things together nice and neat, and people come and do the silent auctions for it. And sometimes, you know, it comes together where, you know, we might have a crazy amount, which is a good thing.
Which would be awesome.
that's what it's all about.
Now, where did you say that people can buy tickets for this here at the club?
Yes, they can come here to the club, we now take credit cards. So if someone wanted to pay with a credit card, the Boys and Girls Club, you know, we're meeting that technology age. So we can take credit cards now, you know, or they can just call the club, stop by. Those are definitely the ways to take advantage of that.
All right. I hope a lot of people come out to this. It sounds like a really fun event.
Well, last year we had a great turnout.
Really?
We actually had to boost up the amount of food for this year because the foot traffic last year was so great that we actually increased the efforts this year to facilitate more people.
That's good. So. That's always a good problem to have.
That's a
more
good
than
problem.
Yes. Now let's go ahead and talk a little bit about your year-end appeal.
Okay.
As well.
Yeah, we during the year-end appeal, after this fundraiser that we're about to endeavor, we always send out a holiday mailer every year. And this is a card that we utilize to kind of get some of those last minute operational funding for the club. Mm-hmm. And it's a really cool thing because we actually highlight a kid's artistic ability here at the club. We have a big competition mm-hmm. where the kids design a card each year, and then we have, as a staff and the kids, they all vote on which one is the best card. And then we go to Garrett's Office Supplies, and they've helped us out over the past, you know, 15 years providing the service to print out the cards. And then we send off the cards out to the community and all of our donors and our sponsors and people that are, you know, have helped us year after year. But it's really neat because we do a bio of the kid mm-hmm. and highlight some of the cool things they like to do here at the club. And of course, you know, they get their artistic abilities sent out to 500-600 people in the community, so it's kind of a nice incentive that we get to provide for our youth.
Yeah, and now those people in the community who do donate to the Boys and Girls Club, what do the funds mainly go for?
Everything goes for operational and for program needs here at the club. You know, everything comes at a cost. I mean, even keeping the lights on just to, you know, facilitate a gym activity. All those things go into basically just making sure that the kids are taken care of that are in our building. And making sure that we have that food program for them running, and make sure they have the physical fitness activities, and you know, and then the social recreation as well.
Now, how many kids overall do you guys provide for or take care of?
On a daily basis, we see between 60 and 80 kids a day.
Wow.
We have approximately 826 active members, mm-hmm. And an active member is a kid who comes 2 to 4 times every single year. So it might be once a month they come, or, you know, once a week or something of that nature. But we see quite a bit of kids that come in here and utilize the services that we have. And, you know, a membership fee for the club is $10 a year.
So that's not bad at all.
Yeah. And we're able to offer that at $10 a year because of the, you know, and I keep saying the support from the community, but because of the support from the community, we're able to offer that at a low price. You know, there's a lot of parents out there that just need help mm-hmm. with their kids during the time. And between 3 and 7, the times that we're open, that's when the kids get in the most trouble. So for us to be able to utilize a cheap way for kids to come in and do something positive and stay out of trouble, I mean, we're going to definitely try to facilitate that. So.
Right, and whether people in the community want to help out through donations or volunteering their time to be a mentor, or just provide a service here that they can do, they can all just come to the doors here at the Boys and Girls Club, right, and sign up?
Yeah, and or just call us. I'm willing to go out to meet people. I'm willing to do anything because it's for the kids. And that's the name of the game here is, you know, providing safe, fun activities for these children.
Right. It's all about the kids. Mm-hmm. Well, Brad, I want to thank you and everyone else from the Boys and Girls Club for being on our show today. We appreciate it.
Well, thank you for having us. I appreciate that.
And remember, if you would like to be a mentor or donate any money to the Boys and Girls Club, be sure to stop by any day of the week and they'll be glad to talk to you. And tune in next week for another episode of Insights.
Insights into Northeast Michigan is produced by WBKB News. If you have any comments, suggestions, or topics you would like to see on a future show, please email WBKB News. This has been a production of Thunder Bay Broadcasting Corporation. All rights reserved.